harbours of Ostend and Zeebrugge are under occupation of the Imperial German Army. The entire coast is fortified from Knocke to Newport. Britain is desperate. German U-boats have sunk thousands of Allied ships and cut off vital supplies. The Imperial German Navy's headquarters are 8 miles inland, in Bruges.
Enjoying the fresh air, Cadet?
Very much, Admiral. It has been a...
Allez, mets dans nous. Pop, tu com.
Keep that mud under control.
Well, I could say the same to you.
Putzer, shoot that dog.
Yes, Admiral.
Von Schroeder, the British Admiral Roger Keyes is preparing a most audacious attack.
As you know, the main U-boat base is located inland, accessible only via the canals. We will effectively seal off the Hornet's nest by blocking the harbours at Zeebrugge and Ostend using block ships. The main obstacle is the heavily fortified harbour wall or mole at Zeebrugge. Our elite troops will land here to clear the artillery and create a diversion for the block ships to enter the harbour. All things are ready if our minds be so. He that outlives this day and comes safe home will stand a tiptoe when this day is named and rouse him at the name of St. George. British Navy vessels create a smoke screen. The Germans fire furiously into it. The wind changes, and the HMS Vindictive and its two escort ships lose their cover. German troops and a mod destroyer fire heavily on the boats. HMS Daffodil nudges the Vindictive against the harbour wall. The landing ramps are lowered. Many Marines are cut down in a hail of bullets. 10 of the 12 landing ramps are shot to pieces.
submarine C-3 lodges itself in the viaduct of the harbour wall. Its crew escape in a skiff, and time-delayed explosives detonate. Ships Thetis, Intrepid, and Iphigenia move in, loaded with concrete and explosives. Thetis takes heavy fire and is scuttled prematurely. The other two ships move into position in the canal. Their crew are ferried away by mortar launches, and they are successfully sunk. The surviving Marines are brought back, and the Vindictive escapes. Next morning, U-boats are still able to pass through the harbour unhindered. Zeebrugge is remembered as one of the greatest special forces actions in British naval history.
Allez, mesdames,